Hi, welcome to a new tutorial. Today we're going to create a write-on effect to create whiteboard animations on After Effects. Whiteboard animations are a great tool to showcase our projects or to showcase any other subject. So this is a pretty cool technique to learn. So I already have Adobe After Effects open, so you should do the same. I already have the files that we're going to use. I have an illustration, which is a great illustration that you can find on Freepik. I have this hand image. All this you can find on Freepik. So as you can see, we have no composition yet. So select your illustration file and you can place it either here on composition or here on the timeline. Once you do that, you create automatically a composition which will have the same size as the illustration. So we have a nice illustration, and for the write-on effect, the idea is that we create the effect that a hand is drawing this illustration. So what we have to do is to make it look like this illustration is being drawn live on After Effects or on the video. So it may sound a little hard to do, but it's quite simple once you know the tools that you have to use. So the first thing that we have to do is to go to the Effects and Presets panel. If you don't see this panel, just go to Window and open the Effects and Presets panel. Once you have this panel, go to the search bar and type stroke and just look for this one, which is on the Generate tab. So with the illustration selected, just double click on the stroke and now this layer will have this effect. Make sure that all mask is selected, is checked right here. So you should have it exactly like this. Now for the write-on effect, the idea is to create a path which goes from here to all the other lines on the illustration and covers up all the illustration so that we can create this effect that it's being drawn. To do this, we're going to select the pen tool. Let's zoom in a little. Remember that if you have an Illustrator file on After Effects, you have to click on this button so that it doesn't lose any resolution. All right, now with the pen tool, just click on this part and start drawing all the lines on the illustration like this. But first, you can see that you are drawing a white line, so it's very important that the brush size covers up all the line. So you have to make it bigger in this case. Right now it's on 2. It should be on 6. Or let's make it 6.5 so that it covers all the line. Make sure it's not so wide because it's going to cover up so much space. So once you have the brush size selected, just start creating all the path until you have covered up the entirety of the illustration. The important thing is that you create a path that makes sense. For example, if you want the hand to draw from here to this point, so you don't have to, you try to follow the path of the illustration, not just go around and creating path just like that. Just follow the path of the illustration itself. If you have any problem with any of these handles, you can just adjust the handles so that it covers all the lines. For example, I have to take this, so you just have to click on this point and fix it. All right, now you just have to follow the illustration as I said, and I'm going to fast forward this part because it's going to take a lot of time, of course, so let's fast forward here. All right, now that we have finished all the paths, you can see that the path is very, very long. Now just end up the path on this part. So when we add the hand goes right here and don't cover the illustration. So with this selected, go to the stroke panel right here on the effect controls panel. And go to this part, the paint style section, and it's now on an original image. Select reveal original image, because what we're going to do is exactly that. We're going to reveal the image with the mask that we are creating, the path that we are just created. Now let's make this the animation will last 5 seconds, so zoom in on the timeline and just go to the second number 5, which is right here on the timeline, and now select this part, the end section right here, and create a keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch. Click here and it should create a keyframe. You can see that the stopwatch is now blue. Make sure that it's on 100%. Now go to the first frame and change the 100% to 0. Alright, now we should have 2 keyframes. You can see this keyframe, if you press the U key on the keyboard, you can see that we have 2 keyframes. Now if we unselect this and let's preview, you can see that the illustration is being drawn right here on After Effects. So that's exactly the effect that we wanted to create. It's pretty cool, right? So now we have to add a hand, because it's now looking like it's drawing itself. So the idea of the whiteboard animation is that a hand is drawing this illustration. So first, make sure that the scale on the illustration is set to 100%. Just click on the S key and you should see the scale attribute, and make sure that it's on 100%. Okay, now with the illustration selected, go to layer and select on pre-compose, because I want to create a composition with this illustration, so that we're sure that we don't mess with anything. Now click OK. Now you can see that it's a composition. You can see this icon, so if you open this, it should appear the illustration file here. Okay, now go to the projects panel and you can see that we have a hand PNG. Place it on the timeline and we have to scale it, but we're not going to scale right here. We're going to first go to layer and pre-compose. You can name it as whatever you want, and now double click on this new composition, the hand composition, and over here go to the S key to open the scale attribute, and on this one you can, let's try on 50%. Let's see how it looks. It's too big still. Let's try 25%. Now it's too small, so it should be around 35. You just have to make sure that when the hand goes to this part, it won't look like this, because of course it doesn't make any sense. So 35 is still looking too short, so let's try 45%, and this should cover up. Okay, now go to the scale button right here and make sure that it's set on 100%. Okay, because otherwise we'll have problems when we create effect. Now select this tool, the pan behind tool, click on it, and this tool, what it does is to change the anchor point position. So right now it's on the middle of the composition of the hand comp, so we have to make sure that the anchor point is right on the tip of the pencil, so that when the hand moves it looks like it's moving right here on the pencil. So click on the anchor point and make sure that it's right on the tip of the pencil. Okay, this should do it. All right, now open up your illustration. Click on this arrow. You can see we have the path right here. Okay, now you will see the masks, the effects, and the transform. Open the masks. Now you can see the masks that we just created. Click on this arrow and select the mask path. Now, with the mask path selected, just go to edit and copy, or press Ctrl C, whatever you want. Okay, now go to the hand comp and press the P button to open up the position attribute. Now, with this attribute, select the position attribute and press Ctrl and B to paste. Now you can see that it pastes all the path on the position attribute of the hand. So what we have to do is to move this last keyframe to the second 5, because as you know, the illustration takes 5 seconds to finish, so this hand should be on the 5th second also. So just move this last keyframe. Perfect. And now if you press the play button, let's unselect all this so that we can see the effect looking nice. Now press the space bar to see what it does, and you can see that the hand is drawing this nice illustration that we can find on Freepik. So that's it for the whiteboard animations. Of course, you can use this technique to create anything. This technique is of course perfect and mostly used on whiteboard animations that are great to explain any subject with a cool effect. So you can see that it's pretty simple to create. You just need to know what tools to use. And of course, you have to know how to use the pen tool on After Effects, which is a little more complicated than using it on Photoshop or Illustrator. So that's it for the write-on effect. I hope that you have some fun and just practice with whatever you want and create some wonderful whiteboard animations. Thank you, and see you in the next tutorial.